is our favorite former NFL star turned TV host here to talk about the new season of
our
Daily
favorite
Mail TV.
Of the many.
Thank you.
That's right.
Thank
is host
you.
Jesse Palmer. Welcome back. So happy to
have
you.
Yeah, so good to be back with you guys. Thank you.
There's so much to talk about, Daily Mail TV, football, everything, but I already cornered you in the makeup room.
Right.
Congratulations on getting engaged. I want to hear everything. You got engaged to your Portuguese model.
To my Brazilian model,
oh, yes.
Out of my league.
Right.
now fiance,
she
yes.
knocked your socks
so
off.
So this was in the Champagne region of France this past
oh my
summer.
Goodness.
I had planned the surprise for like 2.5 months.
Right.
Leading up
yes,
to this. Flights and
so
hotels
beautiful.
And restaurants.
Was she onto it? Did she have a feeling?
So when we got on the flight, I had posted a photo on Instagram saying, hey, surprise trip to Paris. And all of a sudden her phone started blowing up from her girlfriends that were like, it's happening.
Yeah.
It's finally going to happen now. And I had to hire this photographer that took those
right.
photos. He was like a ninja hiding out in the
yeah.
bushes. You know, I had this whole thing going on. And what I forgot to do, and this would be a great lesson to anybody out there and advice who's thinking about getting engaged, you need to get a slim ring box.
Yes, because
okay.
you told
Why?
Me this. This was your advice to me because it...
I just got the
you
ring before we left, and
pocket.
I took the ring, I put it in the bag, I took it to the hotel, I put it in my pocket. I had a Rubik's Cube in my pocket.
Right.
You can't conceal a Rubik's Cube in a suit when you're going out to propose.
You cannot.
No, okay. you can't. So
because
that's proposal 101.
Right.
Ditch the ring box and get a slim
yes.
ring box that you can just fit in your pocket.
Now, you actually took some lessons to learn Portuguese,
correct? Yeah. So
and you did it in part Portuguese?
I did half of it in Portuguese. I had to ask her parents' permission via like FaceTime.
Can you do
in Portuguese,
it?
No.
Yes,
oh,
you can.
It's
on.
Like a kindergarten
just
level.
A
no, season four. Season four,
Dana.
I'll come back and I'll do it.
Just a little.
Ask Dana to marry you.
Respeito muito. Eu tenho uma pergunta para você. That's all I got.
Whatever you
That's
say.
All I got.
Yes.
You have no idea what I just said.
No.
I could have
well,
like,
I heard pregunta, which is question.
Pregunta is a
right.
question. That's right.
Okay.
Yeah, there are similarities. I speak French actually, and that's actually helped me along with learning Portuguese. But it is.
Wow.
It's very difficult.
How long were you guys together?
2.5 years.
Okay, well, that's
yeah.
right.
My
right
mom
now.
Was all over me. She was like, let's go. I got two younger brothers. They're married. Let's get this going. Let's go. Hurry
right,
up.
Right.
So we got the process finally started this past summer. Thank you.
Well, okay, before we use up all the time talking about your engagement, let me talk a little bit about Daily Mail TV. You guys are about to go into your new season. You just won an Emmy. I was there when
Thanks.
You guys won. You look
Thank
so
you.
Surprised.
We were very humbled to win Outstanding Entertainment News Program for our second season. Thank you.
Congratulations. And you actually sat down with the late Playboy model Anna Nicole Smith's ex, Larry Burkhead, and their daughter, Dani Lynn, to talk about her budding entertainment career. Let's take a look at a clip, and then we'll talk about that when we come back.
Last year, she took an acting class, and I got an email from a teacher, and she said Dani Lynn gave one of the most believable performances of the whole entire school that was in the play. And so it's something that, if she's interested in it, if she wants to do something like that when she's older, I'll have my own opinion about it, but we'll see when we get there.
Dani, what do you love about acting so much?
It's really cool to like act as a character and like not yourself. It's like portraying a new person is fun.
Well, I mean, I have so many questions about that, but we're like actually running out of time. Really quick, I think you guys wanted to talk to him about Antonio Brown. Did you?
Yeah.
Yeah. What are your thoughts on that?
The Raiders did just fine without him.
Right.
On AB, the Raiders definitely look good. I mean, can you make up what the drama and the saga was revolving?
Truth is strange.
I mean, here in Los Angeles, this was unbelievable, and all the hardships that John Gruden. Imagine being in his shoes, having to deal with all that, and then try to keep your team focused.
Right.
And to watch them go out last night and play the way they did against a division rival in Denver and play that well. I'm not a Raider fan. I was really, really happy for John Gruden and that team.
I love Gruden.
Kind of worked through that.
Yeah.
You're a big Hard Knocks guy. I already know.
I love
that. He's been watching the documentary on HBO. Absolutely. Yeah, it'll be a fun season.
Would you ever consider doing a wedding type show? Like, you know, you've done The Bachelor. You've done. Would you ever consider doing like a wedding countdown type show?
I think I'll probably keep this one in-house.
I thought so.
We're going to keep it small. I do a lot of TV these days.
Right, you know.
Something's got to be
so pretty soon. I think you could start broadcasting in Portuguese, I'm just saying.
Oh,
right?
You know, 5 more years of lessons. I'll get off my kindergarten Portuguese levels you guys just heard.
I thought it was great. Daily Mail TV Season 3 premieres next Monday. You can catch it right after our 3 p.m. newscast on KTLA every weekday and at 4 and 4:30. We'll be right back. Thank you, Jesse.
Thank you so
congratulations.
Much. Great. Thank you. Thank you.